believe you. We read back in the text. Verse 31 says this. Therefore, take no thought.
Uh-huh.
That's King James. I like good old King. He said, take no thought for what we shall eat, what we shall drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed. Take no thought. What does that mean? Have no care. The ESV says, don't be anxious. Don't be worried about what we're going to eat. Don't be worried about what we're going to drink. When I think of eating and when I think of drink, I think of provision. Dante, I think of provision. What's been provided to me. And it's funny that Jesus is saying here to me, don't worry about my provisions, when everything in the world teaches me I am to prepare my own provisions. You know what the world system says. You work a job, a certain amount of hours, you get a paycheck, and you pay bills. You know the world teaches that you get a job and you work hard. Someday you'll retire, maybe if you can. If not, you keep on working until you're about 70, your knees go out. You know, that kind of thing. That's what the world system says. But what Jesus is teaching us through kingdom knowledge is we're not to take a thought about what we're going to get provided. Come on, not only did he say eat and drink, but he said clothes. Clothes. Clothes represent protection. Represents protection. So he's saying, in essence, don't worry about what you'll be provided or how you'll be protected. Do you know why? I'm so glad that you keep asking me. We're not to worry about that because he will be the provider of those things. You know, in Romans, the Apostle Paul says something like this. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is a reasonable service. And be ye not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Now, how does that work with what we're saying? We got to present our bodies. We got to kill, sacrifice.
Yes, sir.
We have to sacrifice our, you know, and this thing bothered me. This thing really, really bothered me because all of my study of the Old Testament, there's these two words that are sitting right next to each other, and they're dichotomous. You know, they fight against one another. The words say a living sacrifice.
Yeah.
I feel like preaching. I wish it was better. Living sacrifice. Sharita, all of my study of the Old Testament, everything that was sacrificed was killed.
Yeah.
Tell you, now, guess what if I'm wrong? Every sacrifice was a dead. So how in the world are we to present a living? You know how we present a new and living sacrifice? That's what we do in the new kingdom. Under the old rule of the law, it would have to be dead. But when Jesus came, he died once and for all, for everyone that needed to be killed. That's why you gotta kill your flesh and not yourself. It's bringing it under subjection. Sin is bringing it under subjection. Tim is bringing it under subjection. Living sacrifice. Paul suggests over in 1 Corinthians that we should die daily. And you know, we may get frustrated with giving up our provision and giving up our protection. But in 2 Corinthians, the Apostle Paul reminds us, for this momentary light affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory. Because we put our hope in the things which are unseen, not the things which are seen. We got to shift to the new kingdom. Not only must you sacrifice your flesh, but we must also separate from the foolish. Come on.